So north is towards the top.
The image, yeah, mm-hmm. But I'm trying to remember which way north is to have done that.
In here.
On this one. It might
to be honest, for me, it is just knowledge. I'm just so curious. I just want to know. In middle school, Burçin wanted to understand how this mysterious objects in the space works. She still tries to answer the same questions with the same curiosity. So I'm an observational astrophysicist, which means I use telescopes to get images of the galaxies or different objects in the space to understand how the universe works, basically. My focus is to faintest galaxies, which means I require big telescopes, and it is not easy to observe with those telescopes, so it's very competitive. So we can only observe with these telescopes maybe 5 nights a year. The rest of the year, then I'm just analyzing those images that we took. And the goal right now is to find the faintest, smallest, the most dark matter dominated systems in the universe. Right now we know that universe is more than what we can see. It is only 15% of matter is normal matter. Everything else is a mysterious matter that is called dark matter. And what is that dark matter? What kind of role it plays in the galaxy formation? We don't know. But we have so many ideas what it could be. And my group is utilizing these nearby galaxies, these very faint galaxies, to test these ideas because they are the most dark matter dominated systems. They have huge dark matter content with a little bit normal matter so that we can observe them. So they are the cleanest laboratories.
The accretion disk.
As someone with a marginalized background, I didn't have role models that lead me to question myself. Although I had so much passion towards science, many times I question whether this is the place to be. So that's why I really want people to see, to become a scientist, you don't need to fit in a certain box. You can still live your true identity and then still follow your dream. That's why I am collaborating with several scientists. We have a YouTube channel, which is called SciAll, Science for All. This is a group of accomplished scientists from very different backgrounds, sharing their science with a very humanized way. The goal is basically to increase the visibility of these marginalized scientists so that we can change this marginalization and people, we can include more diverse people. And I think by including great minds from different backgrounds, after that we will be able to answer the biggest questions in the universe.